الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. لقد جاءت رسل ربنا بالحق. صلوات الله وسلامه على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر. صدق الله العظيم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. Respected elders, and brothers and sisters in Islam, it was fazl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He granted us this holy month of Ramadan. And we could make ibadat scholars say Ramadan is divided in three parts. First 10 days, days of mercies, rahmah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sheds His mercy upon the slaves and believers who make ibadat. Mercies still continue. It doesn't stop. All the time, everywhere, anywhere, Allah mercy is with us. And with that mercy we are living. We are alive because of the rahmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now with the rahmat, second 10 days, these are the days of maghfirat. What is the meaning of maghfirat? To beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. That Allah forgive us, forgive our sins, that we can become clean before the third part. So with the rahmat there is a maghfirat in the second part. In the last part, last 10 days, these are the days to acquire the freedom from fire of hell, from Jahannam. Two parts of Ramadan already gone. In the last part, few days left. And still we have chance to repent in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and beg forgiveness and ask freedom from fire. It is mentioned in Hadith Sharif that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, find Laylatul Qadr, night of power, in last 10 days. In what hadith Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, find that night of power in 21, 23, 25, 27, 29. Why i'tikaf is made? What is the wisdom of i'tikaf? Scholar says, to do the i'tikaf and to make the i'tikaf to acquire Laylatul Qadr, night of power, to grab that night, i'tikaf is made. And it is necessary for mutaqifi that then they are came in the house of Allah for worshipping and ibadah. They should awake at night after Taraweeh, make ibadat, recitation of Quran, tahajjud, namaz, and dua, and tawbah every night. Not only 21st or 27 or 29, but grab every night and take chance and give time to the ibadah. Then, inshallah, we hope they will get the night of power. And we, who are not in i'tikaf, can they gain something from Laylatul Qadr? They can get something. Yes, they can also get something. Many things, not something, many things they can get. Because in Laylatul Qadr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descending the special mercies after ghurub-e-aftab, after sunset. Mercy of Allah shedding starts. Now Salat-e-Maghrib is after sunset. So from 21 night, if we perform Salah with Jama'ah Maghrib Salah, at least few minutes we will get from Laylatul Qadr. After first, we are performing Alhamdulillah Sunnah and Nafil, and some of us whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given tawfiq, they perform Salatul Awwabin, 6 rakats. So if somebody performs Salatul Awwabin, it is mentioned in Hadith Sharif that he will get the reward of 12 years ibadat. Such great reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is upon us. Afterward we go home, make wazu, we come back to the masjid, we perform Salatul Isha. After Salatul Isha we perform 20 rakat Taraweeh, then 3 witr, then 2 rakat Nafil. So we will also can grab from Laylatul Qadr. And we go at home, recite some part of Quran Kareem. And the last part of the night when we are going to make suhoor, then perform tahajjud salah. So if somebody perform maghrib, taraweeh, isha salah, nawafil, inshallah, he will also get the reward of that night of power. It is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doesn't make mahroom to anybody. His rahmat finds the person where the slave screaming, asking, begging forgiveness, and who want the mercy of Allah. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ready to give and share his mercy upon the slaves, upon the mu'mineen. One short hadith, although there are 3 parts of the hadith, but I will mention only one from them. What the beautiful lessons are given in Hadith Sharif by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to his believers. One companion of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, one day Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was ascending the mimbar. This is mimbar. Upon first step, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ameen. But upon which Rasul-e-Pak sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ameen? What was that? Nobody knows. Companions were surprised. Upon which Nabi-e-Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, Ameen? On the second step, while ascending, once again Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ameen. On third step again Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ameen. Namaz was completed. After namaz, companions asked. Sahaba-e-kiram didn't ask Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more questions, because Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said them, do not ask more questions without necessity. If something necessary, you must ask. Without necessary, more questions useless. Mustn't ask. So sometimes Sahaba-e-Kiram did wait for the travelers to come from outside and ask the question, then they can acquire the knowledge. After namaz, Sahaba-e-Kiram inquired, that O Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, thrice you said, ascending rimbar Ameen. What was that? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Jibreel alayhi salam came. When I was ascending the minbar on first step, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Jibreel alayhi salam said, unfortunate is that person and mumin who got the month of Ramadan and he couldn't acquire freedom from fire of hell. Upon that, I said, Ameen. So think about that. Jibreel alayhi salatu was salam is giving baddua to that person who got the holy month of Ramadan, beautiful month of Ramadan of ibadah, and he couldn't make way to the Jannah. He couldn't enter Jannah because it was the golden and the beautiful opportunity for him, for every moment, to grant this, that he can acquire the reward upon the Amal-e-Salihah, do more Amal, give more time to worshipping and Ibadah, 5 times compulsory Salah with Jamaat, recitation of Quran. After every recitation with dua before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask the forgiveness and ask the Allah ta'ala that, O Allah, your jannat is very wide and open for the slaves. Every day you make free lot of and couple of people from fire of hell. So, O Allah, give freedom from fire of hell and allow me to enter in Jannah by your grace, by your fazl. So, still we are fortunate that we have few days still. We make dua for mu'takifin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept their i'tikaf, their ibadat, their du'as. And we will try, inshallah, go. We are outside, but we come to masjid, make the niyat and the intention of nafli i'tikaf. Whenever we enter the masjid, we must make niyat and the intention of i'tikaf. How long we will stay in masjid, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant the sawab of i'tikaf. What is the sawab of i'tikaf? What is the reward of i'tikaf? Sunnat-e-muakkada alal kifaya. I'tikaf, what Allah grants upon that? On what they are grabbing. It is mentioned in one hadith sharif of Bayhaqi sharif that whosoever make i'tikaf for last 10 days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him reward of 2 hajj and 2 umrahs. Such big reward is given to the mu'takif. So they are very fortunate. We also, when come in the masjid, we should also grab this opportunity to make the intention of Atikaf, then we can also get the sawab of Atikaf. Few days left, brothers. We have to do something, repent in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask the forgiveness and make dua that Allah, you have given tawfiq to perform 5 times salah compulsory with jamaat. You given us tawfiq. So, O ilah al-alameen, give tawfiq after Ramadan also, then we can continue recitation of Quran. We can continue performing salah. We can continue making dua in front of you. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alamin.